Way back in 1978 I found a small, molten, aerodynamic-looking metal stone. It was strange, with a relatively flat face, and a shiny, silvery, finely cracked crust, the other face detected, rough, with evident signs of oxidation rust. It was originally kidney-shaped, non-intact. I was not fasting about notions of astronomy, and I thought it was a peculiar ferrous meteorite. Over the years, I noticed that submillimetric, curious quadrangular black-blue crystals with adamant and luster were present in the shiny and cracked surface, mostly arranged in groups of four. Their numbers grew considerably to hundreds, probably due to the alteration of the thin film crust that hid them. I also discovered that the object, in addition to being very hard, was also relatively fragile, and breaking it gave off a penetrating garlic-like odor, probably due to the presence of arsine and/or phosphine gas. Finally, towards the end of the 1980s, I had the opportunity to speak with experts astronomers, geologists, one of them in particular, seeing the curious submillimetric black-blue crystals, said instinctively, "But these are cosmic diamonds." A few years later I had the object analyzed at a renowned university faculty, and the response, far from definitively clarifying the mystery of the nature origin of the metal stone, made it increasingly thick. The aerodynamic molten object is essentially composed of iron and silicon, I believe in the form of silicides, with also titanium, aluminum. There are a good number of other trace elements among which the gold stands out, with a content equal to 170 grams per ton. It has chemical similarities with ferrosilicon alloys, used in the steel industry as antioxidants, etc. However, it has peculiarities, oddities, anomalies that make one think of something else. For example, the hardness in the metal stone varies from 1,800 to over 5,000 vickers over 9.5 degrees Mohs, on a scale from 1 to 10, scale where natural diamond is the hardest material, 10 degrees Mohs, or 8,400 vickers. While in iron-silicon alloys the hardness at most reaches 1,200 vickers equal to 7 degrees Mohs. I observed one of these minute black-blue crystals with a modified biological microscope, that 750 magnifications, well, they look like quadrangular pyramids, quite similar to some tiny aggregate diamond crystals, found in South Africa. Analysts were also perplexed about other oddities of the object. The phases, I think related to a fusion diagram, were confused, incomprehensible, presence of unusual crystalline forms, never seen before. I remember that because of the remarkable and unexpected hardness, they risk breaking the disc or diamond saw several times, before being able to cut out a small slice of sample. Emblematic, curious, strange. The phrase uttered between serious and facetious by one of the team members who analyzed the metal stone, it would take a medium. The present gold, 0.017 grams per 100 grams, or 170 grams per ton, has and had a market value higher than that of a commercial ton of iron-silicon alloy. The remarkable hardness, even higher than that of the cubic boron nitride CBN, could be explained by the presence of a large number of minutes and very small cosmic diamonds incorporated in leopard spots in the iron silicon matrix. It should be noted that in some rare lithoid meteorites, the aurolites, both iron silicides and microdiamonds, are found associated. Iron silicides have also been found in other meteorites, for example the Dürer 280 lunar meteorite. It seems that masses of iron silicon, almost pure like iron silicides of a certain importance, 8 kilograms, have also been found in the Chiemgau area, Germany, affected by the fall a few millennia ago of a large meteorite, which has produced dozens of craters. Although the evidence cited and the proven presence in the universe of interstellar dust and stray bodies containing iron silicon, many men of science and high-level associations dealing with meteorites are unwilling to accept the existence of a new type of iron silicon-based metal meteorites. Perhaps because they are conditioned by the fact that natural iron silicides are very rare on Earth, as they can only form in particular, highly reducing environments. And perhaps also because the extraterrestrial meteoritic material of that type available in the aforementioned aerolites and lunar meteorites is very scarce and accessory. It is a fact that a few specimens of aerosilicon finished in some meteorite museums have all been considered, rightly or wrongly, all meteor wrongs, / industrial products. However, it must be said that the molten metal object, which I found, unlike the aforementioned iron silicon specimens hastily defined as meteor wrongs, is very similar to certain oriented meteorites. It has two different faces, and seems to have traces of rolled over lip in the border edge of separation. The subtle cracks also recall very much the contraction cracks present in the crust of many meteorites. Such contraction cracks are formed by rapid cooling of the thin crust when meteorites pass through the icy layers of the atmosphere. The corrosion, mostly a rot of corrosion present along the entire separation limit of the two faces, is in some ways enigmatic. However, it brings to mind the so-called roll-over lips of oriented meteorites. Moreover, the diversity of the two faces is practically a constant of the oriented meteorites. It may be that this rot of corrosion has formed due to deterioration. Disappearance of a fragile rollover lip, due to atmospheric agents, air, water, and the humic acid of the soil. Perhaps the object remained buried in the ground the face detected for a few years, up to the upper limit of the alleged rollover lip. There do not seem to be any other explanations for that strange corrosion. After all, observing that thorough, one can clearly see that it is impregnated with earth, soil, as well as oxide rust.